Building on top of the UF5 app we built in the previous episode, we will now dive deeper into the concept of JavaScript controllers in UF5, which allow our app to be interactive. We will build a simple counter that increments by 1 on the click of a button. We start in our XML file, where we set an ID for our text element and change its text to the value 0. Our counter needs a button with a label and also a function that will execute when the button is clicked. We will define the function in our controller file shortly, but while we're still here, let's already import the controller. We can now go ahead and create a controller folder and add our first controller file to it. We import the controller from the library and pass it to a function. This function itself returns the controller again, but we are going to extend it by our increment function, which is triggered on the button's press event. The function grabs the text element by its ID, parses its value as an integer, increments the value by 1, and sets this value as the new text. We can now restart our app by running UI5 serve and see if our counter works. And there we go! The user can now interact with the app. Before we close today's episode, let's do some housekeeping for our project. We move our XML file into a newly created view folder, because that's where all our views generally live in UF5 projects. In our index.js file, we're going to add our view folder to the path for the XML file. And we're also going to delete the Hello World button, which we no longer need. So far, we've used the command UF5 serve to start our app. Let's actually define this as our start script in the package.json, so we can simply run npm start instead. Let's continue in the next episode.